An ACL, or the anterior cruciate ligament, is a strong stabilizing structure in your knee. It's a rope, essentially, that keeps your knee stable. It is one of the most commonly injured ligaments in the knee, and it basically keeps the tibia, or shin bone, from sliding out from underneath the femur or thigh bone. You can cut or stop suddenly, and your ACL can tear that way. Sometimes you can land incorrectly, or you can also get a direct blow or hit to your knee, which can cause an ACL tear as well. ACL injuries typically happen in males somewhere between the ages of 19 to 25 with the most frequency, and in females between the ages of 14 to 18. ACL injuries can also happen in much younger children, and it has been found that ACL injuries in our youngest patients have been happening more in recent years. Females have been found to have more ACL injuries, probably due to their physiology, a combination of strength and muscle balance, their flexibility, and their overall build and alignment. Traditionally, we've described a pop that happens in your knee when you injure your ACL, but you can also have a large amount of swelling, and the swelling could cause your knee to feel unstable when you try to walk and may make walking difficult. On top of that, you may also have some difficulty bending your knee. If you suspect you have an ACL tear, it's best to stop the activity or sport that you've been participating in and rest. Number one, you can ice the knee for any of the discomfort that you have. You can wrap the knee to provide some compression, and then you can also elevate the knee. That helps a lot with swelling. You can also take some over-the-counter pain medications such as Tylenol or ibuprofen to help with any of the discomfort that you may have. And if you suspect you have an ACL tear, it's important to go ahead and see your physician. Typically, your doctor will start by asking about your injury and the history surrounding it. They'll also take a look at your other knee so they have a good knee to compare to. Oftentimes, just by asking your history and then examining your injured knee, we can get a pretty good sense of whether or not your ACL is injured. But still, on top of that, we may order an x-ray or get an MRI just to make sure there are not other injuries that we should be suspicious of and treat at the same time as your ACL. For most patients that are young, active, and participate in cutting and pivoting sports, having your ACL reconstructed is the best option. However, for a small subgroup of patients, those patients that are less active, participate in lower demand activities, they may benefit from just having physical therapy and bracing. They may be able to participate in their daily activities without a functioning ACL in their knee. An ACL reconstruction is basically taking the torn ACL and replacing it with a tissue graft. The type of graft really depends on the characteristics of the patient and their demands. 10 years ago, we would probably avoid an ACL reconstruction in a young child, but nowadays we can reconstruct an ACL without potential harm to the growth plates themselves. Delaying an ACL reconstruction does put your knee at further risk. In terms of the meniscus, which is a shock absorber in your knee, it's oftentimes found to have further injury if we delay an ACL reconstruction. And also the cartilage, which allows your knee to glide back smoothly, oftentimes has more injury if we were to delay the reconstruction. For older patients with lower demand, oftentimes a donor or cadaver tissue for the ACL is acceptable. But for younger patients, research has found that donor tissue oftentimes does not last as long and has a higher rate of re-tears or re-injury to the ACL. So in general, we recommend that young patients have their own tissue used for an ACL reconstruction. There's a number of different training programs you can participate in to reduce your ACL risk. These training programs really focus on core strength, balance, cutting and pivoting, and also plyometric exercises to reduce the risk of ACL tears by improving your mechanics while participating in sports. In terms of after an ACL tear and after an ACL reconstruction, It's important to wait until your knee is fully recovered to reduce the risk of a new ACL injury. An ACL surgery is an in-and-out surgery. That means you come in that morning and you go home that afternoon. In terms of the rehab process, we oftentimes have you visit the physical therapist before surgery so you can learn some pre-surgery exercises and also learn the post-surgery exercises. We have you start exercising the day after surgery, maintaining the knee motion and the knee strength. As you progress in healing and as the rehab process progresses, we start you on more advanced exercises and the exercises become more demanding as well.